All right. Good morning, everyone. Happy Monday. Hope you had an amazing weekend. I am here at the gym about to pop in. Had a little time before my session with my trainer. So I thought I would pop on here and do part five of how to dominate your life in 2019. As you pop on, let me know where you're tuning in from. And if you don't mind, I am, going through my Bluetooth in my vehicle. So Sharon, good to see you on. Margaret, good to see you. Hey, in the comments, if you would, let me know if you can hear okay. Torkel, good to see you. Let me know if you can hear me in the comments below. Can you guys hear me? Fort Worth in the house. Tony from Dallas. All right, in the comments, let me know if you can hear me. We've got UK. UK in the house. All the way from Johannesburg. Laura, good to see you. Who else? Here and see. All right, rock and roll. We will get rocking. Little sun popping out there. All right, so what we're going through, quick recap, this series is all about having force in your life. Most people are a ping pong ball in the ocean. They just kind of float around. They live reactively. If you really want to be powerful, if you want to do big things, if you want to make a massive impact, you need to have your own personal force. And if you want your outer world to be powerful, you've got to make sure your inner world is powerful. And so what I have done for a while is I have my own kind of manifesto that I read through on a daily basis. And it's essentially what just gears me up and keeps my mind where it needs to be, keeps me focused. Today is really more about focus than the previous days. So we talked about the truths of life. If you haven't watched 1 through 4, go back and watch those. A visual representation of your identity, your story and legacy to date. What we went through yesterday is your manifesto, your identity, basically writing out who you ultimately want to be as if you already are. And, you know, this part is just something that I put together. And a little bit different than the past days. And this is a reminder for me of my purpose. So the first thing I have in here is my core purpose. And what I believe to be true is if you're only motivated for money, you are going to have a shallow level of motivation. There's really three levels of motivation. The first level of motivation, which is the shallowest motivation, are things. So material things. And listen, there's nothing wrong with wanting material things. It's great if you want a Ferrari, if you want a big, beautiful home, if you want to have, $50,000 watches, whatever it may be. Nothing wrong with that at all. It's just a shallow level of motivation. You know, when I was young in my teens, early 20s, man, I was so dying to have a supercar. I wanted a Dodge Viper. I wanted a Ferrari. And it was like, that was my huge motivation back then. And if that drives you, that's cool. Let it drive you. But what I realized once I finally got a Ferrari was it was kind of like an empty calorie goal. It was really cool to have, but it was not something that was going to really drive me to produce more. It's not like, oh man, I got to work really hard so I can get a Bugatti instead of a Ferrari. It just didn't do it for me. And I don't think it does it for most people. Even if you're a car person, I don't think that is going to be the huge motivator that's going to give you significance, right? And so second level of motivation is recognition and significance. And so we'll do more for recognition than we will the money and things every time. You know, the thing that's very true about network marketing is you've got to get really good at recognizing other people, because people will do more for recognition than they will the money. And then the third and final level of motivation is purpose. It's destiny. It's calling. And if you can imagine being able to be very clear and imagine knowing exactly why God put you on this earth. What would it feel like? If you knew, if you had certainty as to why God put you on this earth, how would that feel? Okay. Chances are it would feel really good, right? Well, here's the great news. The challenge, most people go through their whole life and they're like, I don't know why God put me on this earth. I don't have any purpose. And they're waiting for their purpose to come to them. My belief is this, is you have the power. God gives you the power to figure out what your purpose is. And so you literally just invent it. You create your purpose. So no more whining about, I don't have my purpose. None of that. No, you create your purpose. Okay. So how do you create your purpose? Well, you write down on a sheet of paper, God put me on this earth too. And you start writing and just keep writing until you get something that really calls you, that gives you some goosebumps, that's like, wow, that feels really good. And it may not be this amazingly extravagant, hugely purposeful thing in the beginning. I remember when I created my first purpose statement, it was something to the effect of to enjoy and give to others God's gift of love, happiness, and passion. That was my initial purpose that was like, wow, that's it. That's what I'm going to live for. I'm going to enjoy and I'm going to give to others God's gift of love, happiness, and passion. And I did that for a while and it evolved and it continues to evolve as you go along. And especially if you're reading it on a daily basis, if you're constantly reading your purpose, you're going to end up developing things that have a little more meaning. So I'll read you mine real quick. My core purpose is constantly growing myself to achieve God's highest calling for my life. And I just added this within the last year, and helping others achieve their highest potential. So that's important for me, it's why I do these videos. I want to help you live up to your highest potential. Now, I can't make you live up to your highest potential, but if I can give you a little bit of direction so that you can do it yourself, then I've accomplished my mission, my purpose. Making a positive impact in the lives of millions of people, enjoying amazing peak experiences and adventures around the world, leaving a legacy of multi-generational love, success, wealth, and contribution for my family, and being a hero to my children. See, I didn't have to read it because I read it every day. I've got it. I've got my purpose memorized. It's why God put me on this earth. So I damn sure better have it memorized, right? And so my recommendation to you is spend the time, do the work, and create the purpose. And if you don't feel like you have the perfect purpose, don't worry. Write it down. Keep doing the work. It will evolve over time. What I find is true is the more personal development I do, the more I'm out doing the things that are gonna get me what I want, the more clarity I get on this. And so don't feel like you have to be perfectly clear on it. And don't feel like, also, remind yourself that God gives you the power to create your own purpose. So you might be wondering, like, you write something down and you go, oh, that feels good, but is that really my purpose? You invent your purpose. You have that power. So next is values and unquestionable standards. So what are the standards that you're going to live by? What are the standards that you live by? What are the values that you focus on? And these for me change year to year. I did this first at Tony Robbins' event. I think it was Date with Destiny. And you go through a values alignment process. He has you put them in order and all of this. So I don't necessarily have mine in any particular order. But I want to have those standards in front of me so I can read them every day. So it's a reminder for me to live those. Okay. And to be intentional about living those standards. And if you remember, one of the truths about life is we don't get what we want. We don't get our goals. We get what our standards are. And so if we're going to attract and we're going to get our standards, you should be very focused on those, looking at them on a regular basis. And also, if you're just tuning in, I appreciate you guys putting where you're in from. If you haven't put where you are tuning in from, put that in the comments below. If you're watching this live, drop me a live in the comments. If you're watching this on the replay, drop me a replay. And listen, if at any point you feel like this is adding some value to you, chances are it will add some value to some others. So hit the share button, and I appreciate the likes, the hearts. Thank you for that. And so here's a handful of the ones that I put down. Number one, happiness. And this is something that I'm reading on a daily basis. So it's a reminder for me. I'm overjoyed with happiness on a daily basis because I constantly focus on the incredible blessings in my life. So this is a reminder for me to focus on the blessings in my life. It's easy. Maybe you can relate to this. It's easy to let stress and overwhelm consume us and forget about how crazy blessed we are. And I don't know what your situation is, but if you've got an internet connection, if you're watching me on Facebook, you are amazingly blessed. If you've not been to some of the slums in the world, if you haven't seen abject poverty, you should probably go do some volunteerism and spend some time in with some people who are way less unfortunate. Anytime I get on a pity party for myself, I think about, you know, being in the slums in outside of Nairobi and the situation that so many people live in. It makes me feel amazingly blessed. Number two, integrity. I'm widely known as the most trusted leader in business. I will never lie to myself or anyone else ever. Confident. I'm confident beyond measure and I always know what to do in any situation. Relentless. I always find a way to achieve my goals. Nothing stops me from getting what I want. Fitness and vitality. I'm a peak performance athlete and amazingly passionate about working out every day. I gain muscle mass every week and I stay perfectly lean. This gives me boundless levels of energy, has me grow younger by the year, and I'm so filled with life, I have a glow around me. So, and then the last one that I just recently added, because I felt like with some things that happened in the past year, I needed to add or re-add peacefulness. So when I feel stress or overwhelm, I remind myself how blessed I am and how much I have to be grateful for. So this is something that I added a few years ago. I was feeling very overwhelmed and stressed. And so I added peacefulness as number one. And I just said, this year, I'm going to focus on being peaceful. I'm going to go to the gym in the morning. I'm going to turn off my phone. I'm not going to let any drama stop me from working out and doing what's going to feed my soul. And what's amazing is I made that year that I focused on peacefulness, number one, I made more money than I had ever made in any year previously. Where the year previous, when I was at the gym and I'd get a call, I'd be like, oh, I'll stop my workout and I'll take this call because there's some drama going on. So I don't do drama. Those of you that work with me, I just don't do drama. I'm not going to let myself get all overwhelmed and pent up frustration and all that with drama. The next thing I put down here, and you know why I do this, there's no science behind this, but I write down achievements and I write these achievements as if they've already happened. This is again, kind of going towards the identity. I built the largest team in the history of network marketing. I've helped over 1,000 people become millionaires, a net worth of over $1 billion. I'm featured on the Forbes billionaire list. I own a 19 passenger Gulfstream G500 private jet. I own a 15 passenger Augusta AW190, 139 helicopter. Got to be able to go from my, home in Lake Travis over to the ranch and so forth, and then pop over to Aspen. Own a 150-foot Palmer Johnson yacht. I own 4 homes, a 10,000 square foot house on Lake Travis, a 5,000 acre ranch in East Texas, a beach home in Florida, and a mountain home in Colorado. I've published 2 New York Times best-selling books. So I'm looking at this achievements, and I'm looking at that like, oh man, these are my achievements. Now, here's the reality. I haven't yet achieved these goals. I've achieved some pretty great goals, but these are, you know, kind of like the pinnacle. And so I'm writing these down as if they're already true. I'm putting myself in that mindset. Now, the next thing I've got here are daily absolutes. And this is a reminder to keep me on track, doing the things that I need to do. Half a liter to a liter of water upon waking up and a gallon every day, reading my manifesto, 20 minutes of learning, writing content for 20 minutes, working out every day, 5 to 6 days a week, a live video every day. So those are the daily absolutes. Next is weekly absolutes. Again, reminder for what you need to be doing. It's right in front of me. I'm looking at it every day. So I'm way more likely to stay on track because it's in front of me all the time. Always have my goals in front of me. Weekly absolutes. Number one is reviewing my goals. And I've got a couple items under that. Reviewing social media stats. tracking my weight. So every Monday I track my weight. My goal is typically to gain more weight, to gain muscle mass. Monthly absolutes. Every month I'm tracking my net worth. So I have a net worth tracker. I track my net worth the beginning of every month. I review my goals in a little more detail. A 1 to 2 day sabbatical for writing and planning. I've recently added that. So, that is something I've got to definitely focus on. Number four is body fat testing. Last thing I've got here are overall 2019 goals. So financial goals, business goals, health and fitness goals, and then my, personal brand as a speaker goals. And then I break out my monthly goals. I actually have my monthly goals on my, daily planner that I look at on a daily basis. And so that's everything for today. I've got one more day we will do tomorrow, and that's my affirmations. And I'll talk a little bit about kind of the psychology behind that and why I believe that is important. So listen, I appreciate you guys tuning in. My wish for you is that you go out and crush it in the biggest way in 2019. I hope you grow more this year than you've ever grown in the past. I hope you're more grateful this year than you've ever been in the past. I hope you realize what an incredible blessing your life is. And I believe all that is possible for you. The reason why I do these is because I just believe in the unlimited potential of everyone. And I believe in the unlimited potential of you. God didn't put you on this earth to just get by. God put you on this earth to do something big. You can do something big. If you're willing to do what other people have done, you can get what other people have gotten. It's just a matter of getting very serious, getting very intentional, holding yourself accountable, going out and doing the work on a daily basis. Two secrets to success is consistency and love of the game. Hopefully you guys can tell I love the game. I love doing what I do so freaking much. And because I love doing it, it's easy to stay consistent with it. And even though I love it, sometimes we need enough willpower and we need enough discipline to be consistent. So in some cases, you're going to have to act your way into a feeling instead of feeling your way into an action. So we definitely need to exercise our willpower and push ourselves to do the things that are necessary. Be excited about the process, fall in love with the process, and you can do that consistently for a very long time. Here's what I've realized is true. It is, most people overestimate what they can do in a short amount of time. It's like, oh, in the next year, I'm going to go from nothing to millionaire. They overestimate what they can do in a short amount of time, but they grossly underestimate what they can do over an extended period of time. If you really knew what was possible for you over the next 10 years, you would be staying very consistent. You would get after it and it would blow your freaking mind. It has blown my mind. If I look at what has happened over the last 10 years, the level to which I've grown over the last 10 years, the level of which my wealth has expanded, my organization has expanded, literally has been amazing. If you would have told me your next 10 years are going to look like this, there's no way I would have believed you. So listen, thank you for tuning in. If you feel like this can add some value, hit the share button. Love to hear comments below. Thank you for the hearts and thank you for the thumbs up, the likes and the loves. And you can always hop over to my website, mattmorris.com. Put your name and email address in there. You'll get my free videos delivered to your inbox every single week. You can also access my YouTube channel through my website. Over 300 videos on there that can add some value for you. Thanks so much for tuning in. Go make life an adventure.